What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Noshong Invitational. We are going to have another best of three. We got London Conspiracy going up against Power Rangers. Now, just looking at the pool of teams, you would expect that these two would probably eventually be floating to the top. And as it stands right now, well, we're not really super far in the tournament right now. This is only round two, and we still have quite a long ways to go. But unfortunately, one of these two teams can actually make it there. Mike Laura is going to be your caster for today. Winner of this is not going to know their opponents just yet because the game that is supposed to determine their opponents has been delayed forever. Hellraisers or Ad Finem. Not really sure what's going to happen there, but hopefully that one is going to be played eventually. But yeah, for sure, you would expect London Conspiracy to be getting pretty darn far in this tournament, if not taking the whole thing. Definitely one of the
10
favorites here.
seconds
Power
remaining.
Rangers, not quite as much so. They have had quite a few
5
roster changes
seconds
as of late.
remaining.
They have found something kind of stable right now, so we'll see how effective they are
Reserve
with this
time.
group of guys. But even though like Bignum, the ultimate mercenary, Arise is bouncing around from freaking everywhere, and I believe that is Cheshire Cat in the last slot. These are all very, very talented players. We'll see how well they actually work together, because London Conspiracy, they've been playing together for quite a long time. Don't have to worry about any issues along those lines, at least not coming from them. So this is probably going to be one of the more even and one of the higher skilled games in this round, at least,
Dire
maybe even
team
some of the
ban.
future rounds as well. But again, unfortunately, only one of these teams can pass through, and we'll take a look at these picks and bans right now. This is a little bit of mid lane hate, and typically when teams go up against London Conspiracy, there's a lot of off lane hate. Lone Druid is going to be banned out first, and then we have an Enchantress as well. Now, Chen is still in the pool
Radiant
on London
team
Conspiracy.
pick.
Will probably not hesitate to pick that one up. They do run that quite frequently. Love themselves some Chen. Alternatively, always grabbing that offlane hero for Kefka is something that London Conspiracy typically do pretty
I
frequently. I
speak
would
for the
expect something
trees.
along those lines. They just profit
Dire
is the
team
pick.
pick.
A hero that is sometimes just completely ignored by these teams, other times is going to be first picked, and it is weird to have a hero that is in a split like that. But hey, if you prioritize the Nature's Prophet, you're going to get the Nature's Prophet most of the time, at least when you're going up against some of these opponents. Power Rangers, of course, we'll know what their offlane situation is looking like right now. Nature's Prophet, you want lots of mobility, you want lots of stuns. We'll see how deep they actually want to go in order to try to
10
counteract this Nature's
seconds
Prophet.
remaining.
More likely than not, they'll just let the safe lane come together
Five
kind of
seconds
naturally. I mean,
remaining.
maybe grab an Oracle early, something like that, just because the hero is so strong. Maybe grab a
Chen.
Chen for themselves. I was, you guys
Dire
could tell, I
team
was
pick.
saying that before they made the pick. I was like 90% of the way there, and then they made that pick, so I'm gonna get credit for that one. Full credit, that is. Well, guys, gotta switch a couple of things in the back end. All right, we happy. We are happy. So Chen is the pick for the Power Rangers side, which normally a couple patches ago actually you would expect Chen would be going to
Ten
some sort of push
seconds
draft or at least
remaining.
some sort of huge tempo game. Nowadays, not as much the case, although it is
Five
definitely
seconds
possible to see
remaining.
Power Rangers try to angle towards the likes of a Juggernaut and then try to get some healing on the board, get some
Reserve
sustain, and then just try
time.
to push down with those really big creeps. Not exactly something that they have to do. They can very easily grab up a Death Prophet. It is here that works okay with Chen. It's not like a huge synergy. I would say like Oracle Death Prophet typically works a little bit better. Get a little bit of minus armor with Death Prophet, that works fantastically as well. But the overarching game plan for both Chen and Death Prophet typically tend to overlap quite a bit. Not to mention you do or you would like to have a little bit of lane clearing if you're going up against Nature's Prophet. Chen has none, and ooh, Batrider is the pick for the Power Rangers
Radiant
side.
team pick.
They're very Power Rangers-esque hero. They play this one pretty darn frequently. And it is another hero that, well, first of all, has mobility, has the stuns, or at least enough stuns to make this Nature's Prophet's life a little bit difficult. And the rat power of London Conspiracy is not to be underestimated, but Batrider is usually the one to squash those rats. At a certain point in the game when Nature's Prophet will probably just be bouncing around all over the place, and it's up to
10
Batrider to try
seconds
to stop him.
remaining.
Batrider plus one, really. I get some sort of maybe even like a
Five
medium
seconds
damage support
remaining.
hero to handle that, and they usually are going to be okay in order to deal with the Nature's Prophet, at least mitigate his damage.
Reserve time.
But again, this is a situation where London Conspiracy, they know that they're going up against a Batrider, and do they want to grab a Vengeful Spirit? Do they want to grab a Legion Commander? Do they want to grab an Oracle? I mean, I would say probably Legion Commander least often seen out of all of those, but for sure, knowing you're up against Batrider is especially second pick, is going to give Colony Conspiracy a couple more very clear options immediately off the bat. Alternatively, going for a Witch Doctor seems pretty good here as well. A little bit of extra sustain for the team with that healing. Not to mention the fact that you'll just be able to cast not as much so the Batrider, but more so the Chen. Although Witch Doctor versus Batrider
Bounty
in the laning phase is
Hunter.
certainly very good. It's going to be instead a Bounty Hunter.
Radiant team ban.
I don't hate it. It's perfectly fine. I personally do like Witch Doctor a little bit more so versus the Chen, but that's more of a response to the Chen once he's already jungling. This is a little bit more of a proactive approach coming out from the Lenny Conspiracy side. Bounty
Ten
Hunter scouting out
seconds
for an Aegis
remaining.
Prophet. You can do some pretty jank things if you get a little bit ahead on the Lenny Conspiracy side.
Remaining.
Track up some people, just teleport in on them. Yeah, you could get some pretty easy
Reserved
kills
time.
on pretty soft heroes. The Bounty Hunter isn't really the best versus the Batrider. The track is not going to be huge in that regard. This is mostly just a tempo hero and a hero to try to pressure the Chen just a little bit. We've seen situations where the Bounty Hunter is not going to do quite as well as he really has to in that
Dire
situation, in
team
which case
ban.
he really does need a little bit of time in the safe lane.
Should have seen that one
And
coming.
really luckily for Lenny Conspiracy, or I guess
Radiant team
not super
ban.
luckily for them, but Jalopy's carry is usually going to be at least a little bit willing to move out of that safe lane. The Lenny Conspiracy side are usually going to rotate around quite a bit.
10 seconds
But
remaining.
Oracle's getting banned out, Death Prophet, all the heroes that I was mentioning before.
5 seconds
Just so you guys
remaining.
know that I am not crazy. I'm actually offering good suggestions
Reserve
here.
time.
For the most part, I guess. Not really sure if Vengeful Spirit's quite the play here for Lenny Conspiracy. I feel like the hard counters to the Witch
Dire
Doctor,
team
Lasso,
ban.
probably that ship has sailed or sold, which is not a phrase, but I guess you could sell the ship as well. If that's really what you want to be doing. Yeah, handling the Chen seems like that's priority number one for the London Conspiracy side.
Ten
Get
seconds
the Bounty Hunter
remaining.
to go in deep. Witch Doctor is a great hero to handle that Chen.
Five
Okay versus the
seconds
Batrider in lane
remaining.
as well. As long as you have someone who can follow up with some sort of either huge burst damage, i.e.
Reserve
Gyrocopter, or
time.
some form of additional disable, i.e. Sven. Either of whom would be pretty much right up London Conspiracy's alley. There is a lot of mid lane hate here for Lenny Conspiracy side. We've seen Baby Knight play quite a wide array of heroes, but are these
Dire
like
team
all the.
pick.
These are pretty much all the mid lane heroes that are ever go towards the mid lane nowadays. I guess you could go like MVP-esque and grab a Phantom Lancer, but like the pool of mid lane heroes, at least your more traditional mid lane heroes, is quite small at this stage. So we'll see what both these teams want to break out for their mid lane. It might just be a mid lane Batrider. They could assume that right now and just chill as it comes.
10 seconds remaining.
Or, offlane Batrider is perfectly reasonable as well.
5 seconds remaining.
On the
Cheer
Conspiracy,
for
they've
dawn.
run Broodmother in the mid lane
Radiant
before.
team pick.
We did see yesterday a Viper in the mid in a Viper picked up. We expected it to go to the mid lane, he didn't. I guess it's kind of a possibility. It's not really a great one here. Yeah, Broodmother's a lot worse than the Spearbreakers in the game. So yeah, you try to do the rat thing with the Nature's Prophet and the Broodmother, but man, Spearbreaker and Batrider can very easily punish that. And Bounty Hunter's
10 seconds
already like going to be on the receiving
remaining.
end of that. Spearbreaker mostly a response to that Nature's Prophet, but also spills
Five
over into that Bounty
seconds
Hunter as well. Just a
remaining.
really good hero versus the two that Lenny Conspiracy have selected. And really, for Lenny Conspiracy's mid lane, unless they're going to
Reserve
go in
time.
for like an old school Windranger Lina type. Windranger actually is pretty reasonable here, I would say. They will feel the pressure of the
Rely
Spearbreaker.
on.
Keep in mind, guys, that Earth Spirit
Dire
somehow is
team
still in the
pick.
pool. Not really sure how that happened. We just you can still grab an Earth Spirit if you want to. I'm not really sure if Power Rangers will be able to fit it into their draft. It will have to be a Spearbreaker core in that case, and that seems really weak. Lenny Conspiracy also, they have their offlane, they have their Bounty Hunter Lion. We have seen occasionally teams dabble with the mid Earth Spirit from time to time, but it's probably not going to be coming out here. I
Ten
actually don't know
seconds
how good
remaining.
Baby Knight is at the hero, or if Power Rangers can put
Five
that in their mid lane.
seconds remaining.
It doesn't seem like it's going to be super viable. I don't know.
Reserve
I
time.
guess it's always possible. The hero is pretty good, but both these two teams do have quite a bit of control already, so I don't really feel like they have to go super deep and try to gimp their lanes in order to try to get extra bits of control coming out from an usually not placed Earth Spirit, untraditional Earth Spirit. Now for Power Rangers, they have a lot of answers for London Conspiracy right now. Obviously, most of them tailored to the first two picks, London Conspiracy, and Lion is most likely just going to be caught in the middle of that. But what is Power Rangers' game plan themselves? Because right now they're really playing off this tempo game, get a fast blink dagger in the Batrider, try to get some kills, but they really need something to
Lunia.
jam that home. And Lina's not quite that hero. Looks like she will
Lunia's
go
team
towards the mid
pick.
lane, and Lina with the Spirit Breaker is super, super dangerous. And Lina versus Chen, Lina and Chen as well. Whoever's going towards that mid lane for London Conspiracy is going to have a rough time, to say the least. Bounty Hunter can poke pretty well at the Lina, but probably not as well as Chen can poke in, or Spirit Breaker can poke in. Lina's also not one of those payoff heroes. We need a really big physical right clicker for the Power Ranger side to really make this pay off. They have so much space creation that they may want to grab a little bit more of a
10 seconds
slower hero.
remaining.
Go into your dabble into your Spectres, into your Phantom Lancers, 5 seconds Power Ranger
remaining.
side. Because they'll have Spirit Breaker, Batrider getting all these kills, and Lina as well, Chen pressuring the lanes.
Dire team ban.
Ooh, but for London Conspiracy, it's going to be a Slark pick. This is pretty common for London Conspiracy. It is a hero that can protect himself pretty decently versus the crowd control effects of Power Rangers. As far as protecting himself against the damage, there is
10
quite a bit of
seconds
it, so Slark's going to
remaining.
have to be a little bit careful. London Conspiracy crafting their own draft in such a way that
Five
they are
seconds remaining.
with this momentum, but also with this payoff. Like, Bounty Hunter is very similar gameplay-wise as far as, the Batrider and the Spirit
Radiant
Breaker, in
team
that you
ban.
typically want to get a little bit of advantage, and then you just snowball onwards from there on out. Nature Prophet, very similar, because you'll be taking your towers and trading your structures out. And then Slark's that payoff hero. Slark is the one to get all of that gold, and Slark's the one who you want to funnel all of the gold into so you can kill off everyone else later. And that's what
Dire
Power
team
Rangers need. They need a
pick.
Slark-esque hero. Again, I'm liking the Phantom Lancer, I'm liking the Spectre here. Slark is going to have a little, couple of issues, actually, versus Phantom Lancer if Power Rangers are going to decide to grab that. In fact, London Conspiracy don't really have that much crowd control at all. The CC is going to have to come from their mid lane, played by Baby Knight, and now that the, well, last mid lane hero in the game is banned out, the Queen of Pain, not really sure what it can be.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I mean, Phantom Lancer is going to mean a lot of problems here for London
Five
Conspiracy. Lion can
seconds
kill two
remaining.
illusions, and that's it. And he's pretty self-sufficient up against the Nature's
Reserve
Prophet,
time.
deals with the Treants pretty decently, can handle the mobs, but not, when everything comes together, he's probably going to have some trouble. Then you just rotate the Chen and the Spirit Breaker in, and
Juggernaut.
most of the time it's going to be okay. Or grab a Juggernaut, that seems reasonable as
Radiant
well.
team pick.
I think I like the Lancer just a little bit better, although Juggernaut is very immune to the Slark as well. Can't pounce him, can't pact him, can't really do anything until your Eye of Skadi comes up, so that matchup is pretty decent. Of course, the Omni Slash is not good versus the Slark, so the Juggernaut will have to be a little bit more careful in that regard. What this Juggernaut has over the Phantom Lancer is potentially a little bit more offensive power versus the Nature's Prophet. You try to sprout yourself and TP
10
away, but
seconds
there's going to be
remaining.
Spirit Breaker, there's going to be Chen, so you might just get stunned anyway, and you can still get spun through the
5
trees.
seconds remaining.
Plus, they get that early combo that I mentioned, Juggernaut healing with Chen and with
Reserve
Spirit Breaker.
time.
Very easy to push down those towers, assuming your
10
Chen has
seconds
any sort of decent
remaining.
start, and of
Where
course,
do
that's
all
up in
the
the air.
weapons?
Whoa, okay, we're going old school here. Magnus for the mid lane, it seems. And we'll see if they're going to switch it up. I don't expect they will. Yeah, Jalopy Slark, Baby Knight, Magnus, Nature's Prophet here as well. All right, so we have a very, very different draft, and that is mostly because all the mid lane heroes in the world got banned out. Power Rangers got a real traditional one, I guess a little bit more traditional one in that Lina. Magnus versus Lina. It is pretty much across the board favored for the Lina. And Magnus is going to be playing the Dragonite in that lane, where he's just going to try to Shockwave occasionally, get a couple of CS here or there. Hopefully for him, he's going to get a little bit of help from his Lion and Bounty Hunter, rotating in with those two heroes, landing some sort of stun or slow. Land a Skewer Shockwave, and Lina's low health
10
pool is going
seconds
to,
remaining.
potentially be her undoing. Of course, the opposite can
5
also
seconds
very easily
remaining.
occur. Oh, jeez. I don't really know why it does that. It just takes a little bit to actually catch up. But
Prepare for
black screen is
battle.
okay, because that it's still working, guys. Don't panic. But yeah, Baby Knight, he's gonna have to save his skewer for when the Chen comes in, when the Spirit Breaker comes in. That's his blink out, right? And the blink has quite a long cooldown. 30 seconds is no joke. He's gonna get quite a bit of health regeneration-wise, and he's gonna get as easy of a time as possible in order to last hit, but it seems like Iron Talon into side jungling just a little bit might just have to be the play here. because there is so much potential pressure going towards him. This observe ward is going to be super important. However, well, it's not really in the most traditional of spots. It is going to see if anyone, of course, comes from this area, but most of the time, the angle that you fear is Chen smoking in from this way, when there's no real observer that you can place that will help you with that simply because it's smoked.
30 seconds to battle.
And, well, the only observer that you can place to see that preemptively is not going to work out because there's sentries and observers here for the Power Ranger side. Of course, they're kind of crossing their fingers, hoping the Bounty Hunter stumbles in. He won't, though. He's going to take out the Batrider's pull camp, and we'll try to protect this south lane as much as possible. But for right now, while everyone's just chilling and waiting, let's see who's going to be playing what. We got Baby Knight playing that in Magnus. I don't think I've seen him play Magnus before, and if I did, it was a long time ago, so we'll see how he performs. Jalopy's on the Slark, he plays that one very frequently. Solon Lion is on the field. We got the K-Man, Kefka, on the Nature's Prophet up towards top lane. Boots first, trying to keep himself safe, and when we got the Bounty Hunter roaming around, it's going to be Beaver. We'll see how much he can get. J4 is going to be handling the roaming Spirit Breaker. He does have Dust first, so he's prepared to deal with Bounty Hunters up towards top. Goddamn is on the Juggernaut. Over towards mid, Arise is on his Lina, and, well, he is Arise, so he should know how to lane against Magnus, you would think. Right now, Bignum is handling Chen. He's going to be pretty unhappy if there's no creeps there, and there's Cheshire Cat on the Batrider with some jank-ass hair. Or hood, I don't actually know what that is, but that's okay. Yeah, Bignum's gonna be pretty upset there's nothing here. And of course, we're gonna have team speak problems. Always team speak problems. Literally all the time. Oh well. Oh well, that's fine. Alright, so on this bottom lane, stick charge is of course going to be pretty important for both the Slark as well as the Lion. Of course, that's not up right now. Killing off the Batrider is very, very possible. Usually, Slark is picked up in response to Batriders in that regard, because it is a hero that, like the Sven, has just another form of CC to drop in. It is going to be Pounce, which is not the best, but Batrider, until he gets level 2, is, yeah, maybe going to take a couple of shots here, actually. He's not in a great spot. I feel like if the Lion just levels up Spike or Hex right now, and if Jalopy just levels up a Pact or Pounce, they could put a lot of free damage into this Batrider. Not to get the kill, but, yeah, the Batrider does have to be very careful in this bottom lane. Doesn't exactly know when Kefka is going to teleport in. Of course, level 1, Nature's Prophet, not going to be teleporting in anytime soon. But, yeah, him coming in, Bounty Hunter coming in, these are the potential threats. So Bounty Hunter, of course, did block this camp, so he's expecting the Chen to come over. I don't actually know what route the Bounty Hunter took to get here. Observer Ward was freshly placed, so I assume that he went up this way. You guys can see on the minimap what I mean. Up this way, like this. If you walk through here, then obviously the Power Rangers side knows exactly where he is. But, yeah, I didn't actually see where he walked in. I guess I could watch it on the delayed stream or pause, but, yeah, they should know that the Bounty Hunter is around here. And they do. And they definitely do. So Batrider is, in fact, going to take quite a bit of damage. As I said, level up Spike, level up Pounce, and that's a lot of free hits. There are quite a few tangos here for the Batrider, but, yeah, Firefly and the Napalm is going to be okay versus the Slark, because Slark can just purge it all off with the Pact, pounce away from you as well. And of course, if he gets a Stick Charge, then, well, he's not going to have to worry about running out of those escape tools anytime soon. We'll see how successful this Bounty Hunter is at dealing with this Chen. A big part of this is that Chen, whenever he grabs a creep, that means he doesn't get experience from it. So we can see, like, this Wild Wing Ripper, he got, like, half of one of the little ones, and half of both of the little ones, so I guess he got one little bird so far. Not exactly a lot of experience for the Chen, and this is pretty much what Bounty Hunter is supposed to do all day long. Eventually, someone is supposed to rotate it and try to, you know, jam the kill home, but for right now, he's doing the best he can. Of course, Baby Knight is suffering because there is no help for him. If the Bounty Hunter was to come down here, Arise would be spotting it, and Beaver's actually now charged. He's going to walk right into a couple of sentries as well. That's kind of unlucky. He has to get out of the sentry range, force the dust out. He will do just that, but still he's in a lot of trouble right now. Six armor, will that hold? Jail. There's a rock toss from far away, and Beaver's going to be first blood. Bignum is going to grab it with a right click from downtown. Rock toss does a lot of damage. Boulder toss? Rock toss? I think it's a boulder toss. Hurl boulder. I was not right at all. But you guys know what I mean. He's throwing boulders, and it hurts like hell. And Arise and Baby Knight, okay, get into a little bit of a fight over towards mid. The Bounty Hunter has teleported in. Baby Knight not going to test the Lina. Beaver actually can go for this because Arise does not have any detection here. Shockwave is there. They get the Orb of Venom proc. There is no Janata. He's only level 1 right now, but a skewer forward. A couple more right clicks, and Arise will get his bottle. And they will call it quits right now. Skewer has a super long cooldown. You don't really want to overcommit. You don't really know where the Chen is. could be right around the corner, in which case things get really bad. Now that they have the Janata, it is a lot more possible that they make this happen, but level 1 Bounty Hunter ganking is not exactly threatening. You really do need that level 2 Janata for that extra bit of slow, especially since Magnus isn't able to pump out that much damage as of yet. So far, Bounty Hunter relatively unsuccessful, and well, this Observer Sentry combo is a big reason why. Now, Bingham knows exactly what's going on right now. He'll expect the Bounty Hunter to pop out, maybe steal a creep or two, or he'll at least get a little bit less experience. But hey, at least he's absorbing some experience from the Chen. It's good enough for the Bounty Hunter right now, as long as he keeps this up. Take a quick look at our side lanes right now. Kefka, level 4, pushing level 5, getting a lot as the Nature's Prophet. A lot of experience, not as much gold. Batrider, not doing quite as well, but definitely can recover a little bit later. And of course, the safe laners are absolutely free farming. The Juggernaut doesn't have quite as much as the Slark, curiously enough. You expect it to be pretty much dead even, but not the case. Oh, Courier, not like this. It's gonna fly right over the cliff, and we'll be fine. And Bounty Hunter's charged once again. This time there's no sentries, but there's still another set of dust here. Hellbear in the way, and they get a bash! And Lina's coming in as well. That's the Bounty Hunter down. Playing with fire for a little bit too long, and Bounty Hunter got burned. 0-2 now in favor of the Power Rangers side. It is looking more and more difficult here for the Bounty Hunter. He should know that there is an Observer Ward exactly where it is. Not really sure if that's going to help him quite enough. Ooh, Batrider. He's going in pretty deep, and he was spotted by the Observer Ward up the cliff. He does not know that he's completely surrounded, however. He does have a double damage rune. He does have Firefly. He's going to try to go for Solan Hex to open up. Waiting for the spike, and, well, it's coming soon. There it is. Baby Knight's going to arrive with the skewer down to the low ground. They have a shockwave. Not quite enough damage, though. Oh, they pushed him too far away. J4 is now going to come into the middle of it, and he's probably going to take a couple shots, but he's a Spirit Breaker. He's just fine. A little bit of a blunder there. If they just didn't skewer him quite as far, just one more right-click from anyone would have done it. Solon was already backing off to the south, though, and I'm pretty sure London Conspiracy are going to be pretty upset at one another for that one. Just a little bit of miscommunication. Expecting who's going to get the hill kill. Obviously, you want it to go towards the Magnus. Bare minimum, you want it not to go into the Lion, but if Solon stuck around, if he was just a little bit more greedy about that, could have gotten the kill for the team. Batrider would have been slowed down just a little bit more, and he probably wouldn't be returning to lane right now. So that kind of does suck for the London Conspiracy side. They will still remain with zero kills. We'll see when Power Rangers' push is going to come. Bingham's Chen is super capable right now. Although they would like to wait to level 5 if possible. They're going to camp out Arise still, who still with no sentry has been pretty resistant to this Bounty Hunter's rotations in. Gotta say that part of it's gotta be Arise playing Magnus so much, he knows exactly what the hero's capable of, so you can keep your spacing, keep moving, dodge a shockwave, stuff like that. The Bounty Hunter is unable to pressure the mid lane, unable to get kills in the off lane. This is a really bad situation for the Bounty Hunter at this point. It can change if he's able to get a kill on either the Lina or the Batrider, or at least get involved in one of those kills. But, yeah, until that happens, he's still going to be on the back foot. Arise is going to be rotating around with Bignum. Observer Ward did see it, but Kefka's still being charged nonetheless. Going to send a couple of Treants out. He does have Phase Boots, but the stun is coming in for J4. That should set up for at least a Hellbear Clap. Centaur Stomp? Oh, it's not even needed. Let's just annihilate him. Laguna Blade was held there as well. Kefka going to be the third casualty here for London Conspiracy as Power Rangers, even with a little bit of vision here from the Radiant. Spirit Breaker is a little bit too strong initiating. And this isn't even like Spirit Breaker at his strongest versus the Nature's Prophet. That comes a little bit later. My Nature's Prophet is trying to rat, but it doesn't really seem like London Conspiracy are going to be ready to do that anytime soon. Kind of falling behind a little bit early on. Their farm is still doing remarkably well. Bounty Hunter and Lion, we can see, they're hurting for gold. They're hurting for experience, and Beaver's going to take control of the pulling, and maybe Lion's going to try to pressure some of these other lanes. He's level 4 with 2 points in Hex, so he's got disables up the wazoo, but again, hexing up the mid lane is possible. Magnus doesn't exactly have a ton of damage in that regard, and that's kind of the weakness of picking up this hero. You do get a little bit of acceleration for the Slark later on once the Empower comes up online. That's about it. Other than that, the hero needs his Blink Dagger, needs to play that Batrider role. But is kind of going to be gimped by the fact that he's going up against Lina early on. Not an easy lane matchup, to say the least. Because they both have the same nuke, except Dragon Slave is, like, bigger. It's pretty much, like, advantage Lina across the board, and that's why we see her pulling away. He has a level advantage over the Magnus. course. Jalopy is able to, in theory, get something like a Shadowblade Link Dagger, then he'll be able to pressure the lanes as well. But Goddamn can do the exact same thing. In fact, Goddamn has been playing a completely free game right now, has barely interacted with everyone, anyone. So, no point stealing more just yet, so plans for pushing doesn't seem like that's going to be coming up anytime soon. But he's going to be farming up a storm up towards the top lane. Again, with no one to contest, eventually he'll be able to chip down this tower. In fact, it's already very weak. And Solon, I don't think he's spotted here. They shouldn't know that he's here, but now they do. But no Spearbreaker in the area means that he should be fine either way. Tower with no healing ward is still going to be dropped. No response from London Conspiracy. They're going to be forced to sack that top tier 1.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And Power Rangers can honestly keep going. If they had a healing ward, oh, they do have healing ward, look at that. If they do have a healing ward, they decide to use it. They can keep going, pressure the tier 2s. Alternatively, Chen's creep army is pretty massive at this point with level 5 on him. They can very easily slide towards the mid lane, make an aggressive play versus Baby Knight, try to take down the mid lane tower. Pretty old school timing here for the Power Rangers side, but still just as effective as always. Healing Ward plus Chen is a legit combo. It makes you, lets you be able to force down structures at a whim. As it stands right now, Power Rangers are just content with farming up this Blink Dagger on Batrider, and he's getting there pretty quickly. Dealt with a pretty nice stack of creeps in this area. Now, of course, is dealing with the double. So, Blink Dagger is going to be coming relatively shortly. On the Conspiracy have no such item. They do have such item. Baby Knight is still farming in towards mid, towards, I would assume, his own Blink Dagger. Blink RP Skewer. I guess that's kind of a lasso, right? It's pretty much the same thing. Slark has gone for a hand of Midas, so he just wants to get to that late game. Not going to get a lot of gold from this early track. In fact, track's not going to be up for a long time, and Arise actually has an angle on Solon. Spearbreaker's charging in from a very far away. Solon needs a Hex. He's going to get it out, but Laguna Blade is going to finish the deal here, and, well, Spike is going to come through. Laguna Blade's still in range. Solon is still spotted. Kaboom! There's an Observe Ward up on the high ground, Solon, and now he knows it. Unfortunately for the Lion. Now, that seemed like it was the play. Just, like, because you can't really outrun Lina when you don't have upgraded boots and she does, so you gotta try to cheese out the TP. But unfortunately, not quite good enough. Jalopy, he's going to get jumped right now. Beaver's in the area, level 2 Shuriken is decent, but it's not quite good enough. Gonna be driven away by all these Chen creeps. Spirit Breaker will cancel his charge in, Baby Knight will reconsider his arrival. Blink Dagger's gonna be coming up for Batrider just a little bit sooner, I feel, than the Magnus. Now, the dream scenario here for Power Rangers is that they get the Blink Dagger on Batrider and uses it to kill the Magnus, denying his Blink Dagger. I don't really think it's going to be happening. Batrider actually doesn't have enough gold for it, so Baby Knight's probably going to get his first. We'll see if London Conspiracy can actually start being proactive in this game. Up till now, it's just been them reacting and kind of taking it as it comes. Kefka does have Teleport. We do have a Bounty Hunter still, so got to remember that. In fact, Kefka's geared up for a lot of aggressive early game. Drums and phase boots. Movement speed galore, but if he does teleport in on any given target, that target is going to take a lot of damage. Can't outrun the Nature's Prophet, can't outdamage him. On a single target basis, Nature's Prophet right now is king. And Power Rangers haven't had to worry about a teleport yet, but don't expect that to stay the case, PR. Pretty sure the teleports are going to be coming soon, especially since Beaver is a little bit closer to level 6. Jalopy has been doing some jungling, abusing that heal from his ultimate. They're able to get level 6 on Bounty Hunter. They will have the Blink Dagger on Magnus, a very battle-ready Nature's Prophet. And even though London Conspiracy are down 4 kills and, 1,500, 2,000 gold, they will be able to recover that very quickly. All it takes is a handful of track kills to get you right back into it. Like most of these assets that we see right now available to London Conspiracy, we haven't seen used yet. Like we haven't even seen a usage of the Shadow Dance. Which usually you would expect by now. The RP the same way. Power Rangers, they haven't used the lasso nor the God Strength. No, not Hand of God. There's no God Strength on them. Hand of God. We've seen one Laguna Blade, no Omni Slashes, no Nether Strikes just yet. So lots of assets that everyone is currently sitting on. Execution and that one fight is going to be huge. The first fight might determine who's going to win the next two or three fights. In that regard, Beaver really would love to have the track there. Extra vision is good enough, but Jalopy's going in deep. He's got to be very careful here. He still knows that he's not spotted because of the Shadow Dance, so nice little scouting here for the Slark. is going to run into a creep wave, and Arise is now completely surrounded. They see him. Blink RP is there. They're going to skewer him way back into Beaver right now. Where's the disable? It's not quite there, but Arise will still fall to Magnus's shockwave. Great plays there for Lundy Conspiracy. Now that's the communication that they needed earlier when they were trying to kill the Batrider. Scout out here for the Slark, make sure there's no one coming. Make sure Lina's all alone, and well, once you get that deep as the Slark, you know that there is no one coming in to help out that Lina. At least if they do, they have to TP in. Jump in, fully commit. That's level 6 on the Bounty Hunter. That wasn't a track kill, unfortunately, for them, but hey, now it's up. Power Rangers, they do have the Blink Dagger, now revealed on the Batrider. Well, it's a stark difference between what the Batrider is doing and what the Mag just did. Blink Dagger to get an ultimate kill on the Lina? That's a huge one. Batrider showing off his Blink Dagger to farm? Eh, kind of underwhelming. Yet still Power Rangers go into the Roche Pit. They have a Chen army, they have level 1 healing ward. Goddamn's actually gone for drums. Seems like Power Rangers are going to look to put on the pressure ASAP. Power will still fall up towards the top lane. London Conspiracy are way too far to actually deal with this. We'll see how much pressure they can put up towards this top lane. They should know more or less what's going on right now. They see no one in the mid lane. They see no one handling up towards top. Tier 1 for Roche Trade is pretty darn good for Power Rangers, honestly. They still have a pretty big Chen army. Level 7 on the Chen. Soon Mechanism is up. Bignum's been getting quite a lot of cash. Now that the Aegis is up, it's time to force down mid lane towers. Lundy Conspiracy should not be able to win an engagement with an Aegis on the Juggernaut. He's just doing way too much damage. Unless Power Rangers just really botched their initiation or something, or get initiated themselves, speaking up towards top lane, Figure of Death is there, and Treasure Cat in a lot of trouble! Oh, teleported right into it! And the charge is coming in, J4 should reconsider, is now gonna get jumped by Jalopy. Couple of right clicks, Pact is there, as well as the track, Shuriken is gonna bounce through, and with the Hand of God, not quite gonna do it. That's two kills, now Goddamn is going to arrive! Oh man, did I just jinx Power Rangers? I'm sorry if any of you guys are rooting for Power Rangers right now, that was my bad. The only way they mess up the fight is if they make a big, big mistake, I say, as Batrider suicides and then J4 gets caught in it as well. And now Arise is in a little bit of trouble. Slark is burstable right now by the Lina, especially with level 2 Laguna Blade, but with no Dragon Slave, that's not quite good enough. She's gonna throw it out. Is that still a kill, actually? No! Yeah, it will be a kill. Level 2 Dragon Slave, level 2 Laguna Blade, rather. And Slark just playing things a little bit fast and loose. Maybe didn't check items? I gotta feel that that's what happened there. Didn't expect the Yule Scepter. Had to pack that off to jam up the Lina's combo. Power Rangers, even though they lost the Batrider, they lost the Spirit Breaker, no big deal. They still have all of those tools available. Everyone's in the right place at the right time. They're gonna go for a push. Probably not just a tier 1, tier 2 gonna fall as well. And if they can get their hands on Baby Knight, oh baby, that will be quite a lot of gold for them. Tower down. And I don't think they should be done yet. They're going up towards top? Yeah, you're not going to catch up to that. He's gone already. But everyone, and I mean everyone, going in towards that mid-tier 2. Now, Lundy Conspiracy do have an RP. They are going to throw out these tracks and shockwaves and everything that they can. But scared of the Batrider, and the fact that the Healing Ward is going to keep this Chen army alive, means that Lundy Conspiracy are probably not even going to try this. Kepka's down in the bottom lane, pushing that one as far as he can. Same thing for the Slark up towards top lane. They'll sack the tier 2 tower. Can Power Rangers go for more? They're going to actually get a charge up towards the top lane. Jalopy is going to pack off the stun. Probably blink into the trees and then teleport out. Yeah, he'll do just that. Batrider, ooh, is going to not see where he blinked. So they will know that he's gone. But do they care? Because there's still a giant Chen army. One of every creep is going to board the arc, and they will go down for these towers. TP is coming in towards the bottom lane. Arise looking for a Yule Scepter. He is fast, but looks like Kefka's just a little bit faster. Oh, Batrider's actually going to go in. Flame Break blind. He's going to take a Wrath of Nature. A big chunk of damage there. A couple more right clicks. He's tracked now. Cheshire Cat went in all alone. He needs a Blink Dagger out, but it's not going to happen. Shuriken's going to cut him off. Baby Knight's still in the area. He's going to get lifted up out of his skewer. Still has a Blink RP soon. But looks like Arise just a little bit too quick. They're going to pop the Drum Charge. They want in. Oh, RP going to miss! It looked like it should have hit, honestly. RP's cast is really weird. But, yeah, RP is down. Power Rangers still have the Aegis. They can go for these towers still. Losing the Batrider is not a big deal because he did not lose his lasso. Although I haven't really been impressed with how ballsy this Batrider has been. The Power Rangers side do still have the ability to push towers. Lundy Conspiracy, well, I guess they kind of do as well with the Nature's Prophet, but it's definitely not to the degree of Power Rangers at this point. A couple of careless plays from the Batrider. We haven't even seen a Blink lasso yet. That should have happened at least twice by 17 minutes in. Big Gnome is actually going to get beaten down by Kefka. He's got the phase, he's got the drums, he's going to get some help from Baby Knight. Blink skewer to cancel TP. And Jalopy's going to steal the kill. How many creeps can they kill? There's a spike onto one, a couple more are blocked, and that's two, three, all dead. Chen is off the board, ladies and gentlemen. With no RP, Power Rangers may feel comfortable enough fighting this, as maybe they'll get actually a blink last. Jalopy's up on the high ground. Rai's gonna blink in onto him. The pack is gonna take off the tornado. He's gonna pounce away. Blink forward. Lasso's gonna catch him again. And Jalopy's gonna get Laguna to the dome. Stomp is gonna be there and it'll piss off Rai's, but yeah, unfortunately the Slark is on the receiving end just a little bit too much. Everyone else from London Conspiracy is gonna bail out. Still overall a decent exchange, I suppose. Could be a lot worse. They have to avoid the fight like the plague whenever they don't have the RP. And even then, I'm not really sure if they're going to be super eager. Oh, jeez. Sorry, guys. My mouse bugged out. I'm not really sure if they'll be super eager to take the fight. The blink initiation from the Magnus is decent, but Batrider is just so much more clean and controlled and so much more guaranteed that Power Rangers are going to look to initiate those fights a lot more so than the London Conspiracy side. They're looking for this courier snipe, though. And looks like the Bounty Hunter is in a perfect position, but he probably will die if he goes for this, honestly. He will get it, but charge? Oh, it's not going to come in. No, it is coming in now. It is not going to land, though. You're telling me I could dodge cows? I'm saying when you're done, you won't have to. That's a pretty nice curse knife. A little bit of extra gold for everyone from London Conspiracy. We'll call that a track kill, because it's pretty much what it is. It's actually better than a track kill, slightly. It's comparable. It's a courier kill. A lot of gold being built up on these heroes. 3k on the Magnus? What is he building towards? Force Staff? Shadow Blades? Those are the two initiation angled tools that we usually see. And I expect some things to appear in his stash soon. Kefka's gold that he was holding going in towards a Lightning Hammer. And it is a Shadow Blade. One-shot Shadowblade with a little bit of extra. That's what threw me off. Okay, sure. Yeah, this is going to be another surprise element, of course, for the Magnus. Going to make his initiation potentially comparable to the Batrider. Up towards top lane, Goddamn's going to get jumped. Hex and Pound Spike, Finger of Death. Goddamn needs the Omni Slash right now. Right clicks, not quite enough. He's going to Omni Slash, and he will throw out the Lion, but with Wrath of Nature, they will make it a 1-for-1 trade. A great 1-for-1 trade as long as Jalopy doesn't die. Charge from J4, not quite up just yet. Jalopy is going to get into a corner right now. Kill the Healing Ward, show it to his boss. Over towards the mid lane, in the meantime, Arise jumps in towards Kefka. He dodged the RP with that. Now he's going to go for the Nature's Prophet. Not quite enough damage, but with Bingham coming in, they will grab the kill, and Arise will still survive despite the jerk. And Baby Knight's now going to get pulled in. LSA is going to bring him down. Jalopy's trying to go for Arise, but he doesn't have enough damage. He's going to be forced to jump out of there. Beaver, being chased out by the Batrider, is going to go back into the fire. Blink forward, a little more Firefly, and that'll be the Bounty Hunter down as well. Oh man, Arise with the sickest of plays on the Lita. Missed the very early portion of that, but either way, kept himself alive. Now grabs an Aether Lens, and London Conspiracy suffer one too many casualties. This Lita is a thorn in their side, a thorn that they really don't have any answers to, aside from landing that RP, man. Get a Blink Dagger on a line, they'll have a really great answer, but Solon right now is going to be the one to get jumped. LSA is there, Dragon Slave, and a couple right clicks to finish him off. Spearbreaker is going to jam the kill home. I think that was a bash in the last hit. Sometimes lucky for J4. 6-11, and Power Rangers looking damn good in this game. They've limited the amount of tracks that London Conspiracy can grab as long as they are able to answer the Nature's Prophet split push. And they'll be able to consistently pressure the London Conspiracy base. Again, with a Spearbreaker and Batrider, answering Kefka should be pretty easy. Or at least a lot easier than some other games. So expect that in the upcoming minutes. London Conspiracy need these RPs to land. And the Shadowblade, Blink Dagger, Magnus still struggling to land those initiation spells. And he's the only one who can really do it. The Slark does have a Blink Dagger. However, Blink Pounce is kind of mediocre compared to what the Lina can bring to bear. Blink Yules, 100-0. I would say Lina probably has a little bit more than the Slark right now. At least as far as threat is concerned, even though Slark has more net worth. Slark is going to have to build into the Eye of Scotty pretty quickly. He's going to clear out a double stack. Not too bad for him. But ultimate orbs, any sort of extra damage is needed right now, because he actually isn't doing that much. He can lean a little bit on this Nature's Prophet, who's doing a lot of damage, actually. Again, despite net worth, like, Nature's Prophet and Lina probably, like, right up there as far as threats are concerned. But even with the drums build, not quite enough health to make it worthwhile, to make it Survivable enough to handle a rise. Ooh, tower being denied by a rise. Jalopy's gonna jump in and grab it. Now jump in for a rise. Draconature bounces through. Does a lot of damage to the Lina, but not quite enough. She's gonna blink out of there. Jalopy now into the Shadow Dance, looking for J4. The Sprout is gonna land. However, he does have a charge straight out there. Take down the rise. And Baby Knight does have another RP right now. He's gonna land it only onto J4, however. Kefka's gonna damage a lot. He's gonna try to be out, but there's no trees here because Baby Knight destroyed them all. Laguna Blade's gonna take out the Magnus, and Lina buys back for a double kill. They're gonna grab the lasso with the Bounty Hunter, and that's gonna be a third. Triple kill for a rise. Buyback, so worth it. Unfortunately for them, Roshan is not being cooperative, so they can't get everything. They will instead just get a hell of a lot. That was a 1-for-3 exchange. A little bit of gold lost there by the Lina even after that buyback and triple kill. Lunny Conspiracy, it just doesn't seem like they're on the same wavelength right now. Like, that skewer through where the Nature's Prophet was really a rough skewer for Kefka. Really need to... I don't know if he would have been able to get out of there if he was actually in trees. It would have been a little bit closer, to say the least. Maybe a Bounty Hunter would have survived because they would have had to lasso the Nature's Prophet. Something along those lines could have happened. But still, it's really good for the Power Rangers side, yet their net worth, you can see, is still not quite comparing to Lunny Conspiracies. Still able to keep up. I think that was a track kill on the Lina, so a little bit extra cash. It is a level 1 track still, however. And these towers, well, just one tower advantage for Power Rangers, but with Nature's Prophet, split push, and just like bouncing around farming everything, being the net worths rather even. Lots of it is being controlled by Kefka. And Slark, oh, he can go for Lincoln Sphere. Unfortunately, Beaver does not have a Lincoln Sphere, so he'll get pulled right back into goddamn couple of chops here and there. And that's a dead Bounty Hunter. Same time, though, they're going to catch up to the Nature's Prophet and kill him off. Whoa! Is that Spiritbreaker solo killing the Nature's Prophet? Holy hell, well, that just happened. He doesn't even have his Shadow Blade yet, so he doesn't have that extra damage component. A little bit of attack speed, I guess. Must have gotten a couple of extra bashes there. It's great for J4, obviously. Horrendous for Lunny Conspiracy. Losing your Bounty Hunter means losing your scouting. Losing Nature's Prophet means losing your pressure. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, what is this? Octarine Magnus. Now, there are very few heroes that... I want to say there's zero heroes where Octarine is a bad item. But is it the best item right now? Because it is pretty, it's pretty expensive, guys. That 2700 Mystic stat, not to mention the 3k Soul Booster, the cost is pretty steep. Jalopy, he's going to move into a little bit of danger zone. He knows that there's an Observer Ward in the area, and he's going to get the hell out of there. He's going to smoke up with the rest of his squad. Batrider is in the trees. They have no freaking clue about it. Baby Knight maybe smells something coming. And now they see him, but they can't quite catch up to him. Roshan, in the meantime, very, very low and is going to be secured here. By goddamn, RP is up. But they have to respect this Batrider lasso. Lincoln Sphere on the Slark is going to be procced off, and J4 is going to dive right into a Hex. They also see Beaver blink in into a Spike. Batrider in bad position. RP now onto three heroes. Where's the skewer back? There it is. There's no follow-up afterwards, however. In fact, the Batrider is still alive. And Magnus, now his toolkit is done. Solon as well. Caught in the LSA is going to fall. Great RP from Baby Knight, but there's just no one to follow up with that. Like, the best case scenario would have been a pact. That's not really going to do it. Power Rangers get a free kill. They draw out the RP, and with the Aegis, they're just going to have to squash these bugs. These rats, rather, off in these sidelines. Kefka's going to try to teleport out, knowing it's not going to happen because of Flame Break. He's going to try to make a break for it, but J4 has something to say to that. Bam. Bam. Dead. Dominating spree here for the Spirit Breaker, and everyone can rejoin the mid lane very quickly. Down towards bottom lane, Jalopy's split push is going to be canceled as well by goddamn. Power Rangers just all over this game, despite what the net worth looks like, which is still a little bit closer than I really would expect. Bounty Hunter is not really getting quite enough for him to accelerate into those Guardian Greaves. In fact, he doesn't even have a mechanism yet, and the Lion is nowhere freaking close to a Blink Dagger. Those type of tools can swing these fights quite a bit. But if seeing as though they're not up, man, you're going to need to... take down the Lina and the Juggernaut, and the Lina, I think, has a kill spree. Does anyone have a kill spree? I don't think so. Maybe the Spiritbreaker has one. He's only died once. Yeah, J4 definitely has one. They do have a gem walking around on the Batrider. And Beaver's going to have to be very careful of that. The London Conspiracy, RP into Spike, I guess, is pretty decent. Nothing really to write home about, though. Their AoE punish with the RP wasn't there. They are still on this split push path. They will have to die to buy space to get a little extra farm. I see Solon is farming up this top lane now. Kefka gonna cut the creep wave as well. This isn't actually safe for the Lion, by the way, so by doing this, he's actually putting himself at quite a large bit of risk. Not gonna get punished right now, but yeah. Maybe next time. Jalopy's instead gonna be the one to get charged. He knows that he is spotted right now. Blink away. Still not getting any dark packed right now. He's gonna pack out the stun into the invis. And last onto the Magnus. Gem is gonna see him. Lincoln Sphere comes a little bit too late. Baby Knight is gonna get beaten down. RP gonna be cancelled. Yeah, he's gonna land onto two heroes. Is that gonna get his escape? There's another charge coming. Will be cancelled by the Lincoln Sphere. Arai's gonna blink forward. LSA to land. And RP now used once again. Baby Knight Magnus cannot catch a break. Over towards mid lane now. Goddamn, gonna force out Jalopy and Beaver. Gonna get his jerk into the dome. Gonna start man fighting up against the Slark, but Slark cannot do this. Can't compete with that Blade Dance. Charge is coming in onto this Bounty Hunter. Charge is going to land. Spin here from Goddamn. Spike a little bit too late. Stun him up. Kefka's going to arrive, and it looks like they do want to fight this even with no RP. Batrider is now going to make his way into the fray. Just a little Firefly everywhere. Solon's gonna get Netherstruck. A couple of hits, and that's gonna be a kill. Everyone else on the conspiracy dispersing to the wind. But coincidentally, all from Power Rangers now find themselves over in the mid lane. Chen's army looking good enough. Dragonflight is here. What is that? Deathwing's Dragonflight? Isn't he the Black Dragon? I don't know. I don't Warcraft. Not anymore. I never World of Warcrafted, guys. It's Warcraft 3 all the way, baby. But this tower is going to fall. Dragon's up in the air. Where is the Dragonborn when you need him? I'll tell you one thing. He might be reviving right now. There is 45 seconds on the timer for an RP. Magnus has Shockwave. He has a little bit of a threat, but it's not quite enough. They're going to skewer Goddamn into the Tier 4s, but an Omnislash is going to go off, kill off the Aegis Prophet. Arai is going to lose his Aegis, but they'll take down the Magnus in exchange. Kefka's going to buy back, but Lina's going to be back soon. Wrath of Nature does quite a bit of damage for Jalopy. He's on the front lines all by himself. They're going to spread up Goddamn, try to make something happen. They'll take out the Healing Ward first, and they'll Finger of Death Goddamn, dump everything into him, but he's going to get out of there even after being hexed. J4 lands a great charge through everyone. They just cannot catch a break. Lightning, maybe he's going to bounce to Goddamn, but I don't think it's going to strike twice. Arise up in the air right now. He's going to fall into Jalopy. Force Staff out. Melee Rack secured. Can Kefka sprout up anything useful? No. J4 is going to try to teleport out. He's tracked, but there's no mana for Shuriken. They'll see the dragons. They will see a couple of extra heroes leave. Bignum is the last one to make his way out. 7-22, and just like that, Arise has to rejoin. Oh, baby. Take Raxes, embarrass the enemy side, and then disconnect. Feels good, man. This is going to be a very difficult game for London Conspiracy to come back into. I have seen them come back from similar situations before, but as it stands right now, they really lack the damage. The Slark has gone for a Lincoln Sphere, and that is absolutely fantastic up against Power Rangers. We already saw how much it did versus the Spiritbreaker, versus the Lina, Laguna Blade, you get the Batrider blocks as well. It's a good item to have, but the hero doesn't do any damage. He needs to get a lot of hits in with that Essence Shift if he's ever going to do any sort of damage. And as it stands right now, he just doesn't have the durability to do it. Doesn't have the backup to do it either. Are we going, guys? Are we going? I want to see how this one plays out. It was a buyback from the Nature's Prophet. Didn't really do... Oh, you could pause while you're unpausing. I actually didn't know that. Nature Prophet did buy back there. He has a lot of items to help him farm, but having died 6 times, the farm state on Kefka is nowhere near where he wants it to be right now. At least Mjolnir at this point. It's 30 minutes in, and this is not quite good enough. It just seems like London Conspiracy have a lot of good items, but... A lot of big items, but these items aren't exactly the best for them. Like this Soul Booster on Magnus... I'm not really sure if there's anything that would really have helped him other than the soul booster. In fact, you know, just the health components probably give him more help than anything else would have. But is Octarine really going to get them out of this? Lower cooldown on Magnus is pretty legit. What the hell was that? Did anyone hear that? I hope something isn't auto-playing in the background. That would suck. Jalopy is going to find two heroes. Gotta watch out for the gem carrier. They're gonna jump in towards Arise. Hex is there. Charge through. Onza 2 is gonna give Arise a little bit more space. So as Yule Scepter, he will use it. Blink out is there. Jalopy is gonna get the kill anyway, though. And now Goddamn also taking a lot of damage here. Jalopy is stolen quite a bit of essence. Baby Knight gonna jump right in. J4 is in Viz. He has a charge angle, but he's not gonna pull the trigger there. Arise to fall. He did buyback earlier, so his respawn timer is quite large. That is a much needed pickoff there for London Conspiracy, but unfortunately, even with that, it was not a track kill. And therefore, it'll just be a minute to delay Power Rangers. It's better than nothing, man. It's better than nothing. But at this point, they need just a little bit more than that. Jalopy still scouting forward. Finds the Chen. This Chen is incredibly fat, but Jalopy has enough damage to kill him off, I feel. God's strength. Hand of God can be not used just yet. In fact, it's not up. Omni Slash will cut through, mostly out to Kefka. Poor guy. Took all of it. Jalopy's Lingazir is not going to hold versus J4. He'll just beat him down. RP onto the Spirit Breaker. Can they burst him down? Jalopy's doing his best with the right clicks, but no, they don't have any detection. They'll skewer him blind, though, and grab the kill. And now working on Goddamn, they'll grab the kill as well there. Up towards top lane, Solon was brought down, just trying to farm his Blink Dagger by the Batrider. But the gem is up towards top lane. While that's happening, London Conspiracy absolutely massacre Power Rangers, finding a lot of time for Jalopy to just hit things. While Power Rangers are all spread out, Essence Shift gets a lot better. He stole a crap ton of agility. Up now to 300 damage a pop with the Empower as well, which, by the way, works off of your base stat and like your base damage. So Empower with Slark gets a lot better because it just scales with one another. Not really sure how much that actually played into it, but man, rest assured, Slark got like 100 something damage from that spell from the Magnus. Not too bad if I say so myself, and now the Ocarine Core is complete. That big push of gold, unfortunately, is not going to affect the Nature's Prophet. It's mostly going to affect Jalopy, and therefore the game plan for Power Rangers should be quite clear. Make sure you disable this Slark. It's a lot easier said than done, honestly. He's got ways of getting himself out of pretty much everything. Lincoln Sphere with the Pact. It's going to be hard to make anything stick on this Slark. But he has the vast majority of the net worth on the Conspiracy. He's the one to dump damage into the RP with that in power. Cleave into the RP. It's something, man. It's something for London Conspiracy. Even being Arax down, they're still fighting and split pushing. Now, if they can find another run like that, they'll be absolutely in stellar shape. The only problem is that that is not going to happen again should Power Rangers all be grouped up. Like this. They're going to group up, still with the dragons in the air. And now, how is the Slark supposed to be able to get in and get all that essence while still survive? I just don't know. This tower is going to be forced down. With no Aegis, they can probably go for a little bit more as long as they respect the RP. They see everyone right now, so they're not going to fear the RP just yet. TPs are going to have to come back right now. Power Rangers can race London Conspiracy very well. Goddamn's going to pop some illusions, Blade Master style, and just go to town in this tower. The RP angle right now, best case scenario, hits onto one hero. Two heroes, maybe. They have a Blink Dagger on the line now, so they have another angle of initiation should they find the chance to do so. It doesn't seem like it's going to be anything more than this tower. Power Rangers walk through the bottom lane, clean it out. Easy peasy. RP with level 2 track can bring London Conspiracy back to parity as far as the gold is concerned. 8,000 deficit, 10,000 EXP deficit is pretty steep. And Slark, well, Lincoln Sphere is on him right now. They have a 4 staff on this Batrider to cancel that. Jalopy is going to get baited in by dragons. And, oof, not going to jump in just yet. That would be a disaster if Slark was to die. Does he have buyback? No, not quite. 20 short. Feels bad. Just kill one thing. You got it. Power Rangers grab the BKB on the Lina. Locking her down with the Lion is going to be easier because of his Blink Dagger, but harder because of the BKB. It's all up to the vision game right now. Power Rangers need to not get initiated upon. They need to stay together, get this Aegis. There's a Cheese Roshan as well, so it should be enough to give them enough gas at least to make an attempt at their axes. They're, of course, going to look for a kill first. Batrider on the front lines, Gem being held, and oh, target acquired. It's Jalopy and Baby Knight. Doesn't get much better than that. They're going to actually lose the lasso to the Lincoln Sphere. No, it's the Force Staff. They still have the lasso. They'll use it on the Magnus, and there he goes. 67 seconds on the sidelines. That's the Roshan at least. London Conspiracy, how much pressure can they apply up towards top lane? Kefka's doing all he can with that Hammer of Thor, but it seems like J4 has some issues with that. Here comes the Space Cow. All the way from bottom lane. He's going to plow right through the Lion. Boom. And, well, Lion is in a lot of trouble, let's say. Oh, he's going to blink out of it. J4 is still going to stun up Kefka. Hex is going to cancel the Nether Strike. Can Kefka teleport out of here? He's going to put the Static Charge on himself. Rise BKB is going to hold. And Kefka should be dropped here. There's no Laguna Blade. They have just right clicks. He's going to sprout himself. That will not help. Solon's going to also drop. Two kills for Power Rangers. And in the meantime, they're still going for Roshan. Goddamn, with the Vlads of Vigdom. Losing very little HP versus the big guy. This is Aegis and Cheese. Aegis for Juggernaut. Cheese probably going to be grabbed by the Chen for a little bit later. Oh. What? Okay, yeah, there we go. Aegis on Juggernaut, cheese on Bignum, probably gonna give it to Lina. And London Conspiracy, they are still on this desperation plan. Split push, hope to not die. So far, that second part hasn't really been working for them. -27 Power Rangers, they are so very close to winning this game. I think if they just take one set of Raxes, the game is over. Like, if they take one set of Raxes, then London Conspiracy needs to take, like, consecutive 5-0s. And that's just so impossible for them. I don't think they had that one good series of engagements, but that's the best it was. Oh, run, Beaver, no! Not like this, Bounty Hunter! There is no gem here. Where is the gem, anyway? Batrider, where are you at? He's nowhere nearby. Okay. Well, Bounty Hunter's gonna live. Sentry on the deck. They'll throw out a couple of tracks here. This fight is all in the hands of the Mag and the Lion. They're gonna jump in towards God Damned to make him scared. They force him to poop out the healing ward. Something, I guess. God Damned not gonna get into a fight with Jalopy. This is perfectly fine for Jalopy because he can back off, heal, and keep the essence. Sprout is not gonna help, and they actually jump in, grab Kefka with the lasso. No damage to him just yet. He's not gonna have a chance to do much, actually, because the dragons are just beating him down. Batrider is gonna grab the kill, Solon to fall as well, and Jalopy's in the middle of no man's land just by himself. He has static charge on him. He's gonna jump down to the low ground, but Omnislash in the backline is gonna kill off the Magnus as Jalopy's still on the run. He just doesn't have enough to do what he needs to do, as goddamn, he's gonna grab a double kill. They drive the Slark out. He only has 9 stacks of essence right now, and Power Rangers are all still healthy. This is looking like game, ladies and gentlemen. There's not much they could do right now. They'll lose both Raxes. Jalopy, he's going to get jumped on. Yule Scepter will be blocked by the Lincoln Sphere. But goddamn is going to say, screw all this. I still have the Aegis. Do we still have the cheese? I don't think they have the cheese still, but they'll take down the tier 4 and the bottom set of Raxes. Mid lane should be pushing in soon. With no buybacks and any other Lincoln Spears heroes, Solon is going to tap out. Good game. Well played. Power Rangers, they out-initiate and out-maneuver London Conspiracy. Bounty Hunter really needed to do more in order to glue the entire London Conspiracy draft together, but unfortunately he just could not get quite enough. Power Rangers Arise doing some pretty sick plays over in mid, styled on the Baby Knight Magnus, who was really struggling all game to land his tools. Baby Knight doesn't really seem like a Magnus player to me. I don't know, maybe he played it way back when, but nowadays, if you pick up Magnus, you better have a damn good game plan with him. And this just wasn't enough. Guys, I'm Mike Lore. It's been a pleasure casting this game for you guys. I should have Danley coming in for game 2, because MRP was a deadbeat. So be sure to tweet him, at MRPDota, and ask him, why are you such a deadbeat? Mike says you're a deadbeat. Do that. Guys, I'll be right back for game 2 between Power Rangers and the Conspiracy. Don't go anywhere.